Androecium, we know that androecium is the third whorl of the flower. So it is the third whorl of the flower. In first whorl there is calyx, second whorl is corolla, third whorl is androecium. It is male reproductive whorl of a flower. And the unit of the androecium is called stamen, or the individual of androecium is called stamen. And stamen consists of three parts. They are anther, filament, and connective. Anther means the functional part of the stamen is called anther, which contain pollen grains. And the stalk of the anther is called filament. And the part, the connective tissue which joins to anther lobe is called connective. That is called connective. And if that stamen is non-functional, that is called staminoid. That is called staminose. If that stamen is non-functional, that means it does not work, it does not produce pollen grains, that is called, that type of stamen is called staminose. So we know that androecium is the essential whorl of a flower. It is the third whorl of a flower. It is male reproductive part of the flower. The individual of that androecium is called stamen, and it consists of mostly two parts. They are anther and filament, but there is connective tissue between two anther lobe, that is called connective. And if anther is non-functional, that is called stamens. So this is about the stamen. The unit of androecium is called stamen. Okay, now we have to say about the number of stamen. If the number of stamen is up to 10, that is called definite number, that is called definite. And if the number of stamen is more than 10, that is called indefinite. Here in this flower, in most stars, in Solanum nigrum, that means in cruciferi, and in case of Solanaceae, the number of stamens are fixed. The number of stamens are less than 10. If the number of stamens are less than 10, that is called definite. Here there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 stamens, so this is called definite stamens. But here, the number of stamen are more than 10. This is your hibiscus rosa sinensis. This condition is called indefinite. That means the number of stamen is more than 10. If the number of stamen is more than 10, that is called indefinite. Now, quiescent. So whether they are attached or free, that is called quiescent. If stamens are free from each other, if they are not united, if they are free from each other, here you can see here stamens are free from each other. Yadi stamen haru ek arkasita free cha. If they are not joined, if they are not fused, that condition is called polyandrous. That is called polyandrous condition. Hey, tell me what is polyandrous? Polyandrous condition. Here the stamens are free from each other. This is called polyandrous condition. But in few cases that stamens are fused with each other. Here the stamens are fused with each other. Their anther as well as filament, both are fused. Right? Anther pani fused, filament pani fused. This condition is called synandrous. Synandrous. Right? Sepal ma gamo sepalos manintyo, petal ma gamo petalos manintyo. Tar esma gamo androus mandaina esma ke mansa. Synandrous vanera mansa. Esma ta ke mansa. Synandrous vanera mansa. Iyo condition man ke mansa. Synandrous vanera mansa. Okay. This is synandrous condition. This is polyandrous and this is synandrous. Are you clear? Number 10 manda kaun bhayo bhane definite. 10 manda body bhayo bhane indefinite. Yadi free chha ni stamens haru ekarka sita bhane polyandrous. Yadi fused chha anther pani fused chha filament pani fused chha that is called synandrous. That is called synandrous. In case of polyandrous condition ma ke huncha, you have studied two conditions, that is didynamous and tetradynamous. Duita condition padnu parcha. Didynamous bhaneko there are four stamens, out of them two outer stamens are short, two inner stamens are long. Two outer stamens are short, two inner stamens are long. That is called didynamous condition. Yesla ke bhaninchha? Didynamous bhanera bhancha. Hai? Ra yadi two outer stamens are short, four inner stamens are long. Haina? There are six stamens. So that six stamens are arranged in 2+4 condition. Two outer stamens are arranged in outer holes. Four inner longer stamens are in inner holes. That is called त्यसलाई हामी के भन्छौ tetradynamous condition. यसलाई हामी के भन्छौ didynamous. In didynamous condition, two outer short stamens, two inner long stamens. हैन two are long हुन्छ, दुईटा लामो हुन्छ भित्रपट्टि हुन्छ, दुईटा छोटो हुन्छ बाहिरपट्टि हुन्छ. भने त्यसलाई के भन्छौ हामी this is called didynamous condition. यसलाई हामी didynamous condition भन्छौ जसमा two outer shorter stamens are present in outer hole, two long stamens are present in inner hole. Hena duita outer stamens, two shorter stamens are arranged in outer hole and two longer stamens are arranged in inner hole. This is called ela ham ke bhanchau didynamous condition bhanchau bhane yadi two outer stamens are short and four inner stamens are long, eta 2+4 condition ho. यसलाई चाहिँ हामी के भन्छौँ, यसलाई चाहिँ हामी भन्छौँ टेट्राडाइनामस. यो ब्रासिकेसी फ्यामिलीमा पाइन्छ. ब्रासिकेसी कुर्सीफेरी फ्यामिलीको क्यारेक्टर हो यो. है यो चाहिँ कुर्सीफेरी फ्यामिलीको क्यारेक्टर. नाउ एडल्फस. अब एन्थरमा चाहिँ स्टामेनमा दुईटा पार्ट्स हुन्छ, एउटा एन्थर हुन्छ अर्को फिलामेन्ट हुन्छ. यदि एन्थर फ्री छ फिलामेन्ट फ्यूज छ भने द्याट कन्डिसन इज कल एडल्फस. द्याट कन्डिसन इज कल एडल्फस. है त्यसलाई हामी के भन्छौँ एडल्फस भन्छौँ. एडल्फस मिन्स फिलामेन्ट्स आर फ्युज, फिलामेन्ट्स आर फ्युज बट एन्थर आर फ्री. होइन एन्थर फ्री छ फिलामेन्ट फ्युज छ भने त्यो कन्डिसनलाई हामी के भन्छौँ एडल्फस भन्छौँ. If filaments are fused in single group, if filaments are fused in single bundle, that is called monadelphous. You condition ma hera, all the filaments are fused in a single tube, single staminal tube. Elai chai hami ke bhanchau monadelphous. But here one is free, other 9 stamen are fused in other group. So here stamen filaments are fused in fused to form two bundle, so it is called diadelphous. Ela diadelphous bhancha. If filaments are fused to form two groups, that is called diadelphous. If filaments are fused to form one group, that is called monodelphous. Tela ke bhancha monodelphous. If filaments are fused to form many groups, haina dherai groups, char wada group dekhako cha, if many groups, that is called polyadelphous. Yo chai citrus सिट्रसहरूमा चाहिँ यो लेमनहरूमा यिनीहरूमा चाहिँ यो देख्न सकिन्छ. यो चाहिँ सिट्रसी फ्यामिलीको क्यारेक्टर हो है पोलिएडल्फस. यो डाएडल्फस कन्डिसन यो चाहिँ तिमीहरूले पढ्ने लेगुमिनेसी फ्यामिलीमा, प्यापिलिनियोसी सब फ्यामिलीमा यो क्यारेक्टर हुन्छ. यो माल्वेसी फ्यामिलीको क्यारेक्टर हो, यो चाहिँ तिमीहरूले पढ्नु परेन. मोनाएडल्फस इफ फिलामेन्ट्स आर फ्युज टु फर्म सिङ्गल bundle. If filaments are fused to form two bundles, if filaments are fused to form many bundles. If filaments are fused to form one bundle, that is called monadelphos. If filaments are fused to form two bundles, that is called diadelphos. If filaments are fused to form many bundles, that is called polyadelphos. Here, if filaments are attached to the petal, if filaments are attached to the petal, that is called epipetalous. E like vancha, epipetalous vancha. In epipetalous condition, that filament are attached to the petal. Hai na filament haru jun cha. तिनीहरू के हुन्छन्? तिनीहरू चाहिँ पेटलसित जोइन हुन्छन्. यस्तो खालको कन्डिसनलाई दिस इज कल्ड इपिपेटलस कन्डिसन. सिन्जेनेसियस इन्सेन्जेनेसियस द्याट एन्थर आर फ्युज्ड. इफ एन्थर आर फ्युज्ड बट द्याट फिलामेन्ट्स आर फ्री. तर फिलामेन्ट्स के हुन्छ? दे आर फ्री. फिलामेन्ट फ्री छ, एन्थर फ्युज छ भने त्यसलाई चाहिँ के भन्छ? सिन्जेनेसियस. त्यो सिन्जेनेसियस हो. सिन्जेनेसियस मिन्स स्टामेन्स are united only by anther, but filaments are free. Filament fused, anther free bhayo bhane adelphos. Anther fused, filament free bhayo bhane syngenesious. If anther are fused together, but filaments are free from each other. That is called syngenesious. Yela hami ke bhanchau? Syngenesious bhanera bhanchau. If you ke bhayo? Anther fused cha, filament free cha. This is called syngenesious. If anther free, filament fused cha, bhane tela adelphos bhancha. Ato adelphos ma monadelphos, diadelphos, polyadelphos, agi bhakkhare bhane maile. And if filaments are fused with petal, that stamens are free from each other. Haina stamen ta free hun, tara from each other, ek arko dekhi free hun. But their filaments are fused with petal. If their filaments are fused with petal, that is called epipetalous. Tell me, what is epipetalous? What is it? This is filamentary. Stamen ko filamentary petal si ta fused baasa bani. Tell me, what is epipetalous? What is it? That is called epipetalous. Okay. Now look here. Yeah, era. यो चाहिँ फिलामेन्ट्सहरू फ्युज भएको छ, एन्थर चाहिँ के छ? फ्री छ. यसमा फिलामेन्ट्सहरू के भयो? फ्युज भयो. एन्थरहरू माथिपट्टि के छ? दे आर फ्री फ्रम इच अदर एन्ड दे आर फ्युज टु फर्म सिङ्गल बन्डल. सो इट इज कल मोनाडेल्फस कन्डिसन. हियर दिस इज कल मोनाडेल्फस कन्डिसन. हियर इन नेक्स्ट फिगर द्याट वान फिलामेन्ट इज फ्री, एउटा फिलामेन्ट फ्री छ. But other nine filaments are fused to form a bundle. So there are altogether two bundles. So it is called diadelphos condition. Here anther free cha, but filaments are fused to form two bundles. So it is called diadelphos condition. Here anthers are free. Here anthers are free. But filaments are fused to form 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bundles. So this is called polyadelphos condition. This is called polyadelphos condition. Here in this figure, anther are fused. There are anthers. These anthers are fused, but filaments are free. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 filaments. They are free from each other, but their anthers are fused. This is called syngenesious condition. This is called syngenesious condition. Here both filaments are fused, anther are also fused. So this is called synandrous condition. If both fused, that filaments as well as anther, if both parts of the stamens are fused, that is called synandrous. If only anther is fused, filament is free, that is called syngenesious. If filament fused, anther free, that is called adelphos. If that filaments are fused in single bundle, that is called monadelphos. If they are fused to form two bundle, that is called diadelphous. If they are fused to form many bundle, that is called polyadelphous.
निशानी दुईटै फ्री भएकोलाई के भन्छ?
दुईटै पोलिएन्ड्रस. सुरुमा भनेको थिएँ नि मैले, द्याट इज कल पोलिएन्ड्रस. पोलिएन्ड्रसको मैले डाइडाइनामस एन्ड टेट्राडाइनामस पनि भनेको थिएँ. इफ द्याट अल दिस लुक हियर स्टामेन्स आर फ्री फ्रम इच अदर, दिस इज कल पोलिएन्ड्रस. दिस इज कल पोलिएन्ड्रस. र पोलिएन्ड्रसमा पनि यो डाइडाइनामस र टेट्राडाइनामस कन्डिसन भनेको थिएँ. दुईटा आउटर होलमा छ स्टामेन, सर्टर स्टामेन, दुईटा इनर होलमा चाहिँ लङ्गर स्टामेन छ भने द्याट इज कल्ड डाइडाइनामस. यदि चाहिँ स्टामेन सिक्सवटा स्टामेन दुईटा होलमा छ, आउटर टू स्टामेन सर्ट छ, फो इनर स्टामेन लङ छ भने द्याट इज कल्ड टेट्राडाइनामस. यो चाहिँ पोलिएन्ड्रस कन्डिसनमा हुने कन्डिसन हो. नाउ लेंथ, लेंथ अफ द स्टामेन बाट पनि वी देयर आर सर्टेन टर्म्स विच आर यूज टू रिप्रेजेंट द कंडीशन अफ द फ्लावर. इफ स्टामेन आर सर्टर देन फ्लावर, यहाँ हेर यो फ्लावर छ, यो फ्लावर भन्दा यो स्टामेन्सहरू दे आर सर्टर देन फ्लावर, सो दिस इज कल्ड इन्सर्टेड स्टामेन. दिज आर इन्सर्टेड, these stamens are inserted, that means they lie below corolla tube, they are inside corolla tube, that means they are smaller than flower, they are shorter than flower, that is called inserted. But if they are longer than flower, then they come out of the corolla tube, this is called exudated condition. This is called exudated condition. In exudated condition, that stamens आर आउट अफ कोरोला ट्युब. स्टामेनहरू कहाँ आउँछन्? कोरोला ट्युबभन्दा बाहिर आउँछन्, त्यसलाई एक्जटेड भन्छ. यदि कोरोला ट्युबभित्रै पऱ्यो भने त्यसलाई के भन्छ? इन्सर्टेड भनेर भन्छ. द्याट इज कल इन्सर्ट. दिस इज इन्सर्टेड हियर, द्याट स्टामेन्स आर सर्टर देन फ्लावर, बट हियर स्टामेन्स आर लङ्गर देन फ्लावर, सो दे आर कम आउट अफ द फ्लावर. दिस इज कल एक्जटेड कन्डिसन. एन्ड now number of antherlobe, if there is only one antherlobe in a anther, that is called monothecous. That is called monothecous. Monothecous anther means the anther with only one lobe. If there is only one lobe in a anther, that is called monothecous. You know, if there is only one lobe in a anther, that is called monothecous. यसमा चाहिँ के छ? एन्थरमा एउटा मात्रै लोभ छ. दिस इज कल मोनोथेकस एन्थर. दिस इज मोनोथेकस एन्थर. बट इन मोस्ट अफ द केसेस इन एन्थर देयर विल बी टु लोभ्स. देयर विल बी टु लोभ्स इन एन्थर. दिस इज कल डाइथेकस कन्डिसन. यसलाई के भन्छ? डाइथेकस भन्छ. होइन, डाइथेकस भनेको एन्थरमा दुईवटा लोभ छ, या यतापट्टि एउटा लोभ छ है, अनि यतापट्टि अर्को लोभ छ, होइन, दुईवटा लोभ. There are two lobes in anther. This is called diathecous. Diathecous भनेको anther having two lobes. And monothecous means anther having only one lobe. If there is only one anther lobe in a anther, that is called monothecous. That is called monothecous. If there are two anther lobes in a anther, that is called diathecous. In most of the cases, anther will be diathecous. There will be two lobes, but in few cases there will be only one lobe in anther. That condition of anther is called monothecous. That condition of anther is called monothecous. In monothecous there will be only one lobe, but in diathecous there will be two lobes. Now fixation. A fixation means attachment of filament to the anther. Of anther ma filament kasari attach bhacha bhanne anusar pani there are few terms which are used to denote it, haina, that is called fixation. How that filament is fixed with anther, how filament is fixed with anther, that is called fixation. Base fixed, if that filament is arise from the basal portion of the एन्थर, एन्थर लोबको बेसबाट, बेसबाट इफ द्याट फिलामेन्ट इज एराइज्ड, इफ फिलामेन्ट इज इन्सर्टेड एट द बेस अफ द एन्थर द्याट इज कल्ड बेसिफिक्स। वर्डबाटै क्लियर छ, इफ द्याट फिलामेन्ट इज इन्सर्टेड, इफ फिलामेन्ट इज ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रम द बेस अफ द एन्थर, एन्थरको बेसबाट यदि चाहिँ फिलामेन्ट ओरिजिनेट भयो भने द्याट इज कल्ड बेसिफिक्स। इफ फिलामेन्ट इज अट्याच टु द डोर्सल साइड अफ द एन्थर, एन्थरको डोर्सल साइडमा चाहिँ फिलामेन्ट अट्याच भएको छ भने द्याट इज कल्ड डोर्सिफिक्स। इफ फिलामेन्ट इज अट्याच अन डोर्सल साइड अफ द एन्थर द्याट इज कल्ड डोर्सिफिक्स। नाउ एडनेट, एडनेट भनेको चाहिँ द्याट एन्थर्स आर एराइज, एन्थर लोब्स आर एराइज फ्रम द बोथ साइड्स अफ द फिलामेन्ट, फिलामेन्टको दुई साइडबाट एन्थर लोब एराइज हुन्छ भनेको एन्थरको बिचबाटै चाहिँ यदि चाहिँ फिलामेन्ट पास हुन्छ भने द्याट इज कल एडनेट। यसलाई चाहिँ हामी के भन्छौँ, एडनेट। बेसिफिक्समा बेसबाट आउने हो भने एडनेटमा कहाँबाट आउँछ, यो बिच पोर्सनबाटै आउँछ है, यो एउटा बिच पोर्सनबाटै आउँछ, त्यसलाई चाहिँ हामी के भन्छौँ, एडनेट भन्छौँ। नाउ भर्सेटाइल, भर्सेटाइल मिन्स द्याट फिलामेन्ट इज इन्सर्टेड इन एन्थर इन सच वे द्याट दिस एन्थर क्यान स्विङ फ्रिली, होइन यो एन्थर के गर्न सक्छ, फ्रिली स्विङ हुनसक्छ भने त्यसलाई के भनिन्छ, भर्सेटाइल। होइन बेसिफिक्स्डमा के हुन्छ, एन्थरको बेसबाट फिक्स हुन्छ, बेसबाट एराइज हुन्छ फिलामेन्ट, डोर्सिफिक्समा डोर्सल साइडबाट एराइज हुन्छ फिलामेन्ट, एडनेटमा यो एन्थरको लोबको बिचबाटै एराइज हुन्छ फिलामेन्ट, भर्सटाइलमा यो फिलामेन्ट एन्थरमा यसरी चाहिँ फिक्स हुन्छ कि सो द्याट एन्थर क्यान स्विङ फ्रिली, होइन एन्थर चाहिँ फ्रिली स्विङ गर्न सक्छ। तिमीहरूले ग्रासेसहरूमा हेऱ्यौ भने यो कन्डिसन देख्न सक्छौ, जहाँ चाहिँ एन्थर फ्रिली स्विङ गर्छ यो फिलामेन्टमा, द्याट इज कल्ड भर्सटाइल। है त्यसलाई हामी के भन्छौँ, भर्सटाइल भन्छौँ। है बेसिफिक्स द्याट फिलामेन्ट इज अट्याच टु द बेस अफ द एन्थर, डोर्सिफिक्स फिलामेन्ट इज अट्याच टु द डोर्सल साइड अफ द एन्थर, एडनेट फिलामेन्ट इज अट्याच टु द मिडल अफ द द्याट सेन्टर अफ द एन्थर, that means at the from it arises from the connective of the anther, and versatile that anther filament is attached to the anther in such a way that it can swing free, that is called versatile. And here this is basifixed, here that filament is attached to the base of the anther, this is adnet, so here filament is running through whole length of the anther, so it is adnet, so here that filament is attached to the dorsal side of the anther, so it is dorsifixed, so this is versatile, here that filament is attached to the anther in such a way that this anther can swing free. Now intros and extros. If this anther face towards the gynoecium, if anther face towards the gynoecium, that is called intros. Tela ke bhancha, intros bhancha. If these anther lobes face towards the gynoecium, your gynoecium, oh, this is the central portion, this is gynoecium. If this anther lobes, this anther face towards the gynoecium, that is called intros. If anther face away from the gynoecium, यदि anther चाहिँ away from gynoecium face गर्छ भने that is called extros. यो extros condition हो antherको भने यो intros condition हो. In intros condition, anther face towards the gynoecium, but in extros condition, that anther face away from the gynoecium. एन्थर चाहिँ के गर्छ, अवे फ्रम गाइनोसियम फेस गर्यो भने त्यसलाई के भनिन्छ, त्यसलाई भन्छ एक्सट्रोज. यदि चाहिँ टुवार्ड्स द गाइनोसियम फेस गर्यो भने त्यसलाई चाहिँ के भनिन्छ, त्यसलाई हामी भन्छौँ इन्ट्रोज. हामी त्यसलाई के भन्छौँ, इन्ट्रोज भन्छ इन्ट्रोज कन्डिसनमा एन्थर के गर्छ